Starlab Space, a partnership between Voyager Space and Airbus, is actively designing, building, and will operate the Starlab commercial space station. This initiative aims to serve a global clientele, including space agencies, researchers, and companies. It will enable a smooth transition of microgravity science from the International Space Station into the new era of commercial space stations. NASA awarded this group over $217 million in total funding via Space Act Agreement as part of the Commercial Destinations Free Flyer Program. Initially, they received $160 million in 2021, with an additional $57.5 million being awarded in 2024. This extra money comes with additional milestones, including for the docking of the Cygnus spacecraft. More on that later in the video. The key partners in this venture include Voyager Space, Airbus, Mitsubishi Corporation, and MDA Space, with plans to launch the station by 2027 or 2028. NanoRacks, now under Voyager Space, leads the Starlab project, leveraging its extensive experience from providing hardware for the ISS, including the Bishop airlock. Their long-standing collaboration with NASA gives them a solid foundation for this project. Initially, Lockheed Martin was set to construct the primary structure, but Airbus has taken over their responsibility. With Airbus's experience from being the prime contractor for ESA's Columbus module on the ISS, they bring not only technical expertise, but also potential business from Europe, vital for Starlab's commercial viability. This shift in partnership has also altered the technical design of Starlab. Instead of Lockheed Martin's proposed inflatable module, Airbus will construct a metallic, rigid structure, similar to those on the ISS. This choice promises a quicker development and lower costs, as metal modules are tried, tested, and well understood, providing a more reliable option under tight time and budget constraints. Starlab. As part of NASA's commercial LEO destination initiative, Starlab features a spacious habitat that can support up to 4 astronauts at a time. It includes a state-of-the-art research lab, multiple docking ports, a 60-kilowatt power and propulsion system, and a large robotic arm for cargo handling. Starlab will launch in one go, fully equipped and ready for immediate use upon reaching orbit. They claim it will have similar commercial usable space as the ISS, but the internal volume seems to be half, so perhaps they mean it will be more efficiently used than on the ISS. Starlab Space announced their space station will be lifted into orbit on board a Starship vehicle provided by SpaceX. This means the space station can be outfitted with all equipment and consumables needed to support astronauts' missions. This rapid deployment reduces costs and technical risk. The station will host a variety of scientific and commercial activities, including microbiology, biopharma, and advanced manufacturing. Starlab aims to provide a comfortable environment, making crew stays more productive. They are partnered with Hilton Hotels, whose architectural team is designing crew sleeping suites and communal areas. Next-gen research facilities. Starlab is equipped with cutting-edge research facilities, including the latest technology for scientific experiments and product development in microgravity. These facilities empower researchers to conduct innovative studies, allow commercial industries to refine their products, and help space agencies push forward human space exploration. Astronaut services. Starlab offers comprehensive support for services for professional astronauts, covering everything from ground-based training to mission planning and on-orbit assistance. They meet the highest standards established by leading international space agencies, guarantee safety and mission success. In October 2023, Starlab and Northrop Grumman partner on cargo transport. Northrop Grumman's Cygnus spacecraft provides cargo to the ISS. Through a new agreement with Starlab, they will develop a fully autonomous rendezvous and docking technology to provide cargo resupply services to Starlab Space. Over a 5-year period, their Cygnus spacecraft will be used to deliver pressurized cargo to Starlab to support future human spaceflight missions. Cygnus has already completed 19 missions for NASA to the International Space Station and provides other services, such as periodic reboosting of the International Space Station's orbit. In November 2023, Starlab Space to work with ESA in low Earth orbit. ESA, Airbus and Voyager Space are exploring opportunities to work together in the post-ISS era. Europe still wants to be able to carry out scientific, technical and commercial activities in low Earth orbit. Through this agreement, they will explore the use of Starlab Station as a possible destination for European astronauts. Using European transportation vehicles for crew and cargo, such as the Nix vehicle being developed by the exploration company, other European space startups such as RFA and PLD Space are also developing cargo vehicles that could be used in the future. ESA wants a smooth transition to the commercial era space stations, so this agreement is useful in thinking about how to move from ISS to the new commercial space stations that should be launching later this decade. In January 2024, Starlab Space selects SpaceX's Starship as their launch provider. Starlab Space announced the selection of SpaceX to launch the Starlab commercial space station to low Earth orbit. Starship, SpaceX's fully reusable transportation system designed to carry both crew and cargo to Earth orbit, the Moon, Mars and beyond, will launch Starlab in a single mission prior to the decommissioning of the International Space Station. Voyager Space CEO Dylan Taylor said that SpaceX is the unmatched leader in high-cadence launches and that the Starship vehicle will be able to launch the Starlab station in a single flight. Starlab will be fully outfitted on the ground and ready to permanently host 4 crew members once launched. In April 2024, Mitsubishi joins the Starlab space program. Mitsubishi, the Japanese industrial giant, joins the Starlab project. Starlab has now grown from a transatlantic partnership into a global partnership. This agreement is expected to expand access to space for Japanese companies wanting to carry out research or science in space. In May 2024, Starlab Space secures 3 cargo missions from the exploration company. Starlab Space has today announced an agreement with the exploration company for 3 pre-booked cargo missions to and from Starlab. This deal with the exploration company, which is developing the reusable space capsule Nix, strengthens ties between Starlab Space and Europe's space sector. The increasing demand for transportation to and from these commercial stations is driving the expansion of the space station market. Starlab will benefit from services by various cargo providers from North America, Europe and Asia. In May 2024, MDA joins the Starlab space project. MDA, the Canadian robotic arm developer, joins the Starlab project. MDA is best known for the Canada Arm, the robotic arm used on the International Space Station for berthing vehicles and performing various mission-critical activities outside the ISS. MDA can provide a full range of external robotics, robotic interfaces and robotic mission operations to the station. No other company can provide such a range of robotic activities as MDA. The addition of MDA Space to the Starlab space team reinforces the joint venture's commitment to assembling an international consortium of strategic and high-profile companies with flight heritage and proven experience, including Voyager Space, Airbus and Mitsubishi Corporation, further expanding Starlab Space's global partner network set to expand the commercial space economy. The US, European, Japanese and Canadian industry partners enabling the continuation of the International Space Station partner network via commercial entities. Upcoming events. All commercial space station projects must submit their final proposals to NASA to be considered for awards expected in 2026. These awards will be fixed price service contracts. The market views these stations as needing NASA as an anchor tenant to have any chance of being viable, making securing the NASA award crucial. The competition is not limited to previous NASA awardees, such as Axiom Space, Blue Origin, or Northrop Grumman, but could include SpaceX, using their Starship as a space station, and also Vast Space, that we've covered extensively on this channel already. In fact, any US-based company is free to make a proposal. One fly in the ointment is that with the change of the US administration, a new NASA administrator will be appointed, likely to be Jared Isaacman. While Isaacman supports commercialization, significant changes in human exploration policy might occur, so we should be cautious about current dates and schedules. We'll keep you updated on the progress of Starlab Space and other commercial space stations in development. Be sure to like and subscribe so you'll see our upcoming videos. We make videos every week covering the space industry, with an emphasis on the smaller space startups that aren't covered so well on other channels. See you soon!